यू नीड टू यूज डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स फॉर आर्टेरियल एंड वेनस डॉपलर्स. आर्टरीज आर लाइक मिलिट्री पर्सन्स, दे आर मोर डिसिप्लिन्ड, दे विल फॉलो द ऑर्डर्स ऑफ द बॉस, दैट इज द हार्ट, एंड दे विल हैव अ डेफिनेट कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन इन सर्टन सिचुएशंस. इफ द स्टेनोज दे विल शो इंक्रीज वेलोसिटी, दे विल फाइंड कोलैटरल्स ईजिली बिकॉज देर इज पॉजिटिव प्रेशर. वेन्स आर लिटिल बिट लाइक ले पर्सन्स, दे आर वेरीड एज द बिहेवियर ऑफ ले पर्सन इज वेरीड. इट इज नॉट ग्रूम्ड लाइक अ groomed like a military, and they have their own ways of doing, and therefore you have to use multiple techniques in their evaluation.
Hello. There is few questions, sir. What is criteria of a vein to be labeled as varicose veins?
Varicose veins is the dilatation of the superficial veins. You label the incompetent perforators and the junction. Junction, as I have told, saphenofemoral junction incompetence more than 1 second is taken as incompetent. And for the perforator, diameter 3 to 3.5 millimeter and the incompetence more than 500 milliseconds, that is taken as incompetent.
How to report varicose veins and perforators?
That I have shown in the PPT. That you have to be regional. You have to mention whether there is junctional incompetence at SFJ or SPJ. Then you have to mention about whether there are thigh perforators, and in leg the perforators are divided into upper, mid and lower, and then into posterior tibial, paratibial, anterior tibial. In the great saphenous vein area, in the short saphenous vein area, there are gastrocnemal, soleal, paraachelial and the lateral. So, as per their anatomical location, you should report it.
So, one question was there, whether we will be getting certification of this program when we are seeing it.
At present, the medical council doesn't allow webinars and online programs to for certification. I think some organizations have approached them. Let us see. I'll request Dr. Amit. To take up this issue with the MMC, at least they will start some hours to certification, because credit hours are required. But I think you should not attend programs for credit hours. You should attend them for increasing your competence or knowledge in that particular field. So we move on to next case. What are his complaints?
There was from JSV to popliteal vein. Sir, stream has gone offline, so they want to get it repeated.
JSV to
popliteal vein.
Okay. Now there was a loss in between.
There was a stream loss.
There was stream loss in between. In this case,
for a minute, sir.
Okay. We'll try to see again.
Now.
Sir, this is a 57-year-old male patient who is a canteen owner, and he has a long-term standing occupation. He is complaining of pain and swelling over the medial aspect of the left leg, and this might discoloration of the left lower leg.
So he, if you can see, focus it here, you can see the pigmentation, dark pigmentation around the leg. Thoda uthun basa, Marathi samajhte? Ha. Ye kiti divasapasun hai? This is long standing, he says. There is some swelling around the medial malleolus, if you can see. Nasa diste ka ito phuklela? Okay. So he has got hyperpigmentation. There are few veins, but they are not tortuous as such. You can see then here. Khaj jate ka? Okay. So he has got complaint of itching on the in the leg region. So we'll start again in the usual way. We'll go back. The machine goes back to the normal position for abdomen screening. Adjust myself so that I am comfortable. Doko khali theva? Doko khali theva hai sir. विल गेट बैक टू द एब्डोमिनल प्रोब. नाव काय तुमचं? सो विल जस्ट एंटर हिज नेम. And we start with the abdominal probe. Apply the jelly here. Put dilative acha. Aramatra. If you talk with the patient becomes more relaxed and he knows what, and you can explain to him what you are going to do. Or just discuss with him his clinical features. So in the transverse section we are seeing this aorta here, the IVC besides, that is IVC, that is aorta. IVC it quite is not much dilated, but we'll try to see. This is long section of the IVC. We'll quickly see whether it is patent. Yes, it is patent. I will not go into details. We had seen in earlier case. So directly come to the extra-iliac region. Confirm whether we are. What is the area? This is extra-iliac artery and vein. Vein is seen very nicely. If you want, you can just sample it. This is the common iliac artery and the below is the common iliac vein. So they look patent and our job is over as far as pelvis is concerned. We'll go to leg, change our probe, go to the venous setting and go to the saphenofemoral junction area. हे असं धरून ठेवायचं इथं 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 हा बस पायडीला ठेवायचं. हा थोडं माझ्याकडे सारखं अजून थोडं. यस. सो आय हॅव मेड हिम कम्फर्टेबल. गेट हिम क्लोजर टू मी सो दॅट आय डोंट हॅव टू स्ट्रेच माय हँड अँड आय कॅन डू द एक्झामिनेशन इझिली अँड क्विकली. If you want, you can again palpate the artery and see, or otherwise just keep the probe in the inguinal ligament and you see the common femoral artery and common femoral vein. That is it. We come down to see that the femoral vein, superficial femoral vein and femoral artery here. Go back to our area. What we observe here is this is the big vein, the saphenofemoral junction. The great saphenous vein is quite dilated. You can see that it is within the fascia. So this is a femoral vein and this is not a tributary. So there is one tributary coming here that is going posterior, so that would be maybe posterior circumflex. And if there are more tributaries, we'll just try to see this small tributary joining in here. This could be anterior accessory. This is one tributary. This could be posterior accessory. I'll show them again. So at the junction, I am going to medial side, the GSV is in that fascia. I'll adjust the focus so that you can see it in a better fashion. See this, this is the saphenous fascia. In the saphenous fascia, the GSV is there and this is that eye appearance that is called. The vein is dilated. We'll trace it from the junction down. So there has one tributary has come here and as I am coming down, this is one small vein that has come. See that vein? That vein is going into the superficial plane. That vein was in the superficial plane, and as it comes towards the insertion, it pierces that fascia and joins the great saphenous vein. So that could be a circumflex vein. As I come down, this one vein here also tributary joins the saphenous vein here. So these are the tributaries that you see. One more tributary is seen. This is a bigger one. This is the anterior accessory vein. You should always look for this vein whenever there are varicosities. This is a quite common site or important tributary of a GSV. So we know that the vein is dilated. We know there are multiple tributaries. We could identify them. It were not identifiable in the earlier patient. So we go back to the junction and try to assess whether there is a incompetence. Before that, we will just quickly see about the deep vein. So I'll get the focus down so that you see it better. In the transverse section, the artery and vein, that is the junction. Port fuga, sodunda. What are you are seeing? This is the assessment in the transverse section. This is the junction. The flow is red. On my color scale, the red is going down. So this is flow is going from the GSV into the femoral vein. Port fuga, I am asking you to do Valsalva, and visibly you can see there is a reflux, right? So you can confirm this on spectrum Doppler and then put a spectrum here. The angle correction is not required. We are not measuring velocities. Angle correction is required only when there is velocity. See this, he is quietly breathing and you can see the reflux. You are not required here to do a Valsalva also. He is breathing quietly and you can demonstrate that. Again, you can reduce the PSV and see it better. See that. I'll just put the spectrum here and just a minute. See this. It'll increase the box so that you can appreciate the emptying and coming out of the blood. See that. It is incompetent at rest also. So if you are fortunate, you can see this. Otherwise, you have to exert and try to see the reflux. So this is significant reflux here. We'll just confirm by putting spectrum. So that is the reflux part. We will measure the time. The time is more than 1 second. So this is abnormal. And if you ask him to do Valsalva, it will be, the reflux time will definitely increase. Port fuga. See the amount of reflux. There's a huge reflux, continuous reflux. You don't need a Doppler to do this. Even the clinician can say there is a reflux in such case. But our role is more than that. Our role is to see the implications of this reflux. Alternatively, you can see same thing in the long section as we had seen in the normal patient. Just do a long section, keep your hand somewhere resting, wait and adjust the color scale, and you can see the reflux. Here the blue is going away, blue is going towards the junction, red is coming towards me. At rest also there is some reflux. Port fuga thoda. See, there is a huge amount of reflux, and this reflux, there must be some additional findings in this patient. We'll try to see them. So in this patient, we'll try to see whether the reflux is there in the anterior accessory vein. This is the anterior accessory. Come down. this is the vein. Need little bit practice to see them. Flow is coming up. That means coming towards the junction. Pot fuga. Sudunda. Reduce the scale so that even if there is small amount of reflux, we should be able to see. You are not worried about the color bleed outside. Pot fuga halu. Sudunda. So there is no much reflux. Try to see at this point. Fugua port. See, there is change in the color of the, that is GSV. This is GSV. This is changing color on the Valsalva maneuver, but our vein of interest is not showing change. So this is competent. So the tributary is competent, and that is important for us to mention. The clinician will not be able to see that. Other tributaries are not dilated, so we need not see them, or we can see them as well. So this is one of the tributary. You plan it, image it properly along the long section, and then make proper steering. We'll just reduce the little bit gain. That is the GSV down. So the flow is blue. Flow is going away from the probe. Flow is going towards the saphenofemoral junction. Now, thoracic fuga. Sodunda. But we'll just increase the PRF little bit. Increase the gain. How port fuga? Our probe pressure has to be very little or negligible, then only. Otherwise, if I keep my probe like this, this will get compressed and I will not be able to see like this. So probe pressure, see this. Probe pressure makes a lot of difference in evaluating superficial vein, more so in the tributaries. Port fuga, sodunda. So apparently there is no reflux in this vein. So we trace our GSV down and try to see whether there are any perforators in the thigh region, as they are common. So there are multiple small tributaries, but nothing is piercing down. So we have reached the leg region here, and the vein is dilated. So you can see it up to the medial malleolus level. So there is no thrombophlebitis, there is no thrombus in the vein. You can keep compressing at particular distance so that the patency is confirmed. Every time you need not do color Doppler. Okay. So the parent vein, the deep vein, we have seen common femoral was patent. We will just confirm about the superficial femoral vein. Do proper steering, do scale adjustment, and then do a spectral Doppler. So this port fuga, sodunda. Fuga port. What you are seeing here is flow is coming towards the probe from knee to thigh side. This is normal flow in a vein. Port fuga. Sodunda. What you could appreciate here is what was happening. This was the normal flow. Patient did a Valsalva, and you can see there is a reversal of flow here. And then after cessation of Valsalva, again the anti-grade flow came. What is this? This is a deep vein reflux. We'll see it again. Port Fuqua. See that on the other side, you can see the flow. Increase the gain little bit. Sodunda. Fuqua. See it nicely on the other side of the scale. That means sodunda. So that is the intravenous reflux. Why there is intravenous reflux? While screening, we could find there is a vein that is piercing here. This is the vein coming from the superficial plane and down here. If we can see in transverse, we can see it better. See this. I'll show it again. In a transverse section, we are seeing the superficial femoral artery and vein. One more thing, while screening in transverse, we have found that there is a duplication of superficial femoral vein. The case I showed you, there was thrombus in the both these superficial femoral veins. You can see it here. At this point, there is only one vein. You come down, see here. At this point, there is a joining point between the other vein. And these are two femoral veins. They get compressed when I do a compression. And these two veins, they will show venous type of flow. You can see this. This is a duplication of superficial femoral vein. Better appreciated on color flow. And we should always look for it and confirm that there is no thrombus in either of the vein. So we come back to femoral vein assessment. Something is coming out. See it here. Suddenly a big vein is coming out and it is traversing, going quite in the intramuscular plane, going to the lateral side. We really don't know. It is becoming smaller in size, so difficult to see it. Like this, you can see multiple cross channel opening in a venous system. We'll try to see whether what type of flow it is getting. Port Fuqua, Sodunda. See, there is again a reversal of flow in this. You can term this as a perforator because it is going across the plane. Fuqua port. Sodunda. We'll assess again. At this point. Fuqua. Sodunda. Adjust little bit. Fuqua. Sodunda. So once you are sure that there is a reflux, then you can move on to the next segment. Fuqua. See that. It is showing long reflux. So that is a definitely a perforator, and you should always look for it. We go to popliteal segment. थोड़ा सा खाली ठेवा पाय. ढीला ढीला ठेवा. हाँ. So the findings in this patient are SFJ incompetence gross, deep vein reflux in the femoral vein, and there is a big perforator in the mid to lower thigh region. Till this point, there is no DVT either, right from IVC to the femoral vein. सोडून द्या आता आरामात राहा. पॉपलिटल सेगमेंट, द पॉपलिटल व्हेन अँड द आर्टरी. यु सी इट हिअर. कन्फर्म आर्टरी अँड व्हेन. सो व्हेन अपियर्स पेटंट. पोर्ट फुगवा. sodium there. It is also showing reflux, intravenous reflux. Well, try to see if you are seeing any additional finding here. Those are the tibial veins. There, that is the junction of tibial vein and the popliteal vein. That is probably the short saphenous. We'll see whether it is dipping down. It is dipping down, but it is continuing to in the thigh, and that is the extension of the small saphenous vein there. So I'll just check again in a long section. Whether there is any other vein there. Yes, there is a vein here, there is a tortuous vein here. You can see it. It is draining in the popliteal vein at this point, but it is coming from thigh region. We'll just try to see whether there is a flow and what is type of flow in this vein. Port fukwa dara sodunda. Port fukwa fukunta. Shows same type of flow, but the flow is coming towards the probe. That means normal direction of flow. Whether this is Giacomini vein or not, we will have to see. But there is definite vein here. We will try to do a compression and try to see whether there is reflux. No, there is no much reflux there. Right. So utun basata. We'll ask him to sit so that these tibial veins get properly filled and we can see them nicely. No, no, assist him. Take on the khali. Aramat theva. So we'll be interested in the posterior tibial segment because the great saphenous is incompetent. We know that. So here, our deep segment, that is the tibial, they are compressible. Just quickly we finish that, they are compressible and there is no DVT. Then we move on to the superficial segment. So it is compressible, compressible, compressible. It becomes very easy in a transverse section. So what else we are seeing here? There are multiple small tributaries or dilated channels in superficial plane. Some are crossing, are they crossing and coming in the deep plane? Yes, if you see here, this is entering here at this point. This is entering here at this point. Confirm from above downward. So that is a GSV. See the tributaries, they are usually anterior to the GSV, superficial to the GSV. So there are multiple tributaries. This is probably a perforator because it is perforating the fascia into the deep plane. We'll try to see it later. Try to identify whether there are any more connections. This is, there are some channels, they are interplane. This is muscular plane. They are going here, there. In chronic cases, you can't label from where the perforators are coming and going. You can see here it is traversing the fascia. It is close to the other perforator we have seen. So there are two adjacent perforators. We can say it in lower segment, posterior tibia. We come down. One more is seen here, that is perforating into the posterior tibial vein here. So he has multiple veins and multiple perforators. Small perforator here. I'll reduce the depth so that you can see it better. One more perforator here. The internet connection sometimes goes off, and that is beyond our control. So we are screening this patient, had a saphenofemoral incompetence, large incompetent vein in the mid thigh, and you can see multiple perforators here, those who are traversing into the deep fascia. So we will try to see whether they are refluxing or not. We will see this perforator, we will measure it first. What is the diameter? It is 2.5 millimeters below the threshold given by many people, but we will still try to find out what is it, what is the flow pattern there. Our settings are low, we had set them to very low level. Now the Valsalva won't work, so we do either a distal compression. Thoda squeeze it for 2 seconds and then relax. Hello, the mic. I have not done anything. Hello. See, this is working. Dekho. It will take some time. Yeah, hope I am audible, and then we are evaluating this perforator for reflux. We will just do a distal squeeze. Squeeze, relax. Squeeze again, relax. Squeeze. So you can see this. After squeezing, this flow is increasing and there is a small amount of refluxing, that is a blue flow. The perforator was showing a normal red flow because in this setting the red is going down into the deep fascia, and that was showing that flow, and after squeeze it is showing some amount of reflux. We'll try to support our finding by putting a spectrum across it. Do little bit steering, or try to keep the steer to center, whether we can see it better. Again this way. No. Okay. Squeeze. Relax. So it is showing some amount of reflux. I will just put a spectrum across and try to document the time, reduce the sample volume, keep the probe again there, squeeze, relax. So there is incompetence, but it is not much. If we measure the distance, it is close to, it is 400 milliseconds, it is close to the criteria. You can take it, you can mention that there is a reflux, but the time is 400 milliseconds. So we'll try another perforator that was seen. This we have just evaluated. There was some another perforator just beside it. This is the one. We will measure this perforator size. This is again of same size, that is 2.6 millimeters. We'll assess it by color. Put try to put it as per the flow direction, increase the gain, no, there is no spontaneous flow across, squeeze it, relax. So again you can see the flow increases and there is a reflux in the reflux afterwards. We'll try to measure it for how much milliseconds it is and then accordingly. Even smaller perforators, if they are reflexing, we should mention in their report because they can be symptomatic. Squeeze, relax. See that squeeze increases the flow and then there is a reflux. Alternatively, one more maneuver has been described is to compress the proximal vein. What we can do is just at the site of perforator, just compress it and you can see that it reflexes. This is the normal flow. Put a spectrum here and compress it proximally. You can see it is coming towards the probe. That means it is showing a reflux. So in both maneuvers, this particular perforator is showing reflux. The second perforator, we will see it by other maneuver, whether it is showing reflux or not. We will just compress the vein proximally. See, it is showing reflux. So most of the authors have given the maneuver as a distal compression or a distal squeezing. For calf, you squeeze the lower leg. For lower leg, you squeeze the foot. But some have given that proximal compression method also. So there are two adjacent perforators in the mid leg. We'll try to see. There was some more here in the lower leg region. There are in the foot region also, we can see some channels. This is the perforator in the foot region, if you can see here. That is from the deep to superficial, but it doesn't appear dilated, so we'll leave it as here. There is soft tissue edema and there is one more perforator here, big one. So we'll do some, try to do some steering. Squeeze and there is reflux. So again, there are multiple perforators, and in this patient it is always be good to draw the diagram of what you are seeing. You can mention there are multiple varicosities in the leg region. You can mention there are at least three perforators. Each perforator you must see for the incompetence, and then measure the size, measure the time for which there is incompetence, and then accordingly put it into the diagram and the label. So with this we finish this case, and if you have one more we will do that. Utha tumhi, zala tumsa. Dhanyavaad.